Yeah, homie.
So before we get into the deadlift predictions for the Rogue Invitational 2021, I wanted to give you a look at the prize purse because it stands out among all other strongman competitions. What you're seeing here is the prize for the overall show, but if we scroll down a bit, you'll see the way they're doing it is they're breaking it up into a cash prize, Bitcoin, and ticket sales, so they're giving a share to all of the competitors. And so if you come down here and click on the Strongman Purse tab, you'll see that the first place finisher will be getting 8.97% of the overall purse, which is currently at $127,728, a lot more than most other competitions. They're saying the greatest ever in a strongman competition, and it's only rising. So if there are more ticket sales, then that contribution will go up even more for first place. Second place, as of right now, comes away with $63,793, and the third place podium finisher, $38,304. Even the 10th place finisher will come away with $3,845, which in some competitions is first place. So that's very interesting. The way that Rogue did it was they put $1.25 million of their own contribution into this pot, which is incredible, and that is broken up into $975,000 in cash and $275,000 in Bitcoin, right? So that's not strongman only, it's the whole purse, but you can see they made a major, major contribution to try to have a partnership to bring strength sports up as a whole. So awesome to see that. Starting off with our deadlift predictions, I have, as you see, the rating for Luke Stoltman, 29.29. That's out of 100. And the way that I compute that is, if you were wondering, is I take all of these athletes and look at every time they've competed in this event or some sort of deadlift for max, for example. They could be from different heights and whatnot. But I have a database of all these guys. So you'll see the athlete in column A. These are all the guys competing in the Rogue Invitational 2021 and the different contests where they did deadlift for max and how many points they earned out of the possible points. So you get a percentage of points earned there, and I aggregate that over all of the contests, at least in their 10 shows or more for some guys, and determine an aggregate of their rating in that particular event. So Luke Stoltman rates 29.29. I think he'll get 1.5 points here. I think he splits it with Mateusz Kwiatkowski, who is considerably better. So he's 39.76% in deadlift for max over his career, but you're not going to have guys doing deadlift for max and doing a dozen different weights. So I think these two gentlemen come away with the same pull. Moving on up, Mikhail Shivlikov rates 64.76, so I'm giving him 3.5 points. If he's still injured, though, all these points are going to be blown out of the water for him, but we'll give him the benefit of the doubt and say that over his career, he's rated fairly well on deadlift for max. Moving on up, we have Martins Lisis, who has rated not quite as well as Mikhail, 58.50, but again, that's not enough of a difference that one's going to have a greater pull than the other. I think they split 3.5 points. Jerry Pritchett has averaged 72.28% points earned on deadlift for max over his career, or at least in the last 10 shows I tracked. 6 points will go to him. I think that 6 points gets split with Brian Shaw, who has rated considerably lower, 62.05, but I think Jerry's a bit hurt, so I'm dinging him a little lower than what his overall career numbers would indicate. And I think that 6 points gets split also with Tom Stoltman, who has averaged 66.79% of points earned in deadlift for max over his career. And then we move on up to the next level or the next weight. So I think Rob Kearney pulls the next highest weight. He's averaged 70.88% of points earned out of points possible on deadlift for max in his career. I think that 8.5 gets split with Alexei Novikov, who you'll see the number considerably lower now, 61.25. But Alexei on the rise in his max deadlift and has been doing extremely well lately. Now, if you watched Laz and Liz's video, they talked about how Alexei really benefits a lot from a suit. Shaw, for example, JF Caron don't like suits so much. So maybe in this particular event where deadlift suits are not allowed, Alexei suffers a bit, but I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and give him 8.5 points here until proven wrong. And if he doesn't do it, then that goes into my average for next time. And then I think JF Caron wins this event if he's fully healthy. He has averaged 86.23% of points earned over points possible in max deadlifts over his last 10 shows, an astounding figure. He comes away with 10 points. So that's how the deadlift for max will shake out at the 2021 Rogue Invitational. Let's have a look at the Sear dumbbell by clicking here.